with more research, we're hoping to be able to fine-tune the earthquake hazard probabilities along this part of the East Coast.
We're actually really excited to be a part of this. This is not something CORIS has done before, partnering with scientists.
Think of the subduction zone as a machine. So what we're trying to do is understand the lubrication system of the machine, because where you've got a good lubrication system, it'll slip slowly. But where the lubrication system jams up, then you store a lot of energy, which is then released in a very large earthquake.
Today we're at Tologa Bay, 20 kilometres north of Tologa Bay, where we're connecting a GNS electrode to the CORIS copper network.
It's a mixture of high tech and low tech. There's some high tech chemistry inside, and a piece of wood and PVC pipe. So the CORIS copper wire network is what connects all this up, and it saves GNS the time and money of laying very long wires along the roads.
All right, we just let that cool down.
Perfect.
The phone lines run 20 kilometres back to Tologa Bay Exchange, where the other electrode locations will also return to on CORIS copper cables.
This place is very similar to Japan, where we have very large earthquakes. The Hikulan plate has some slow slips, and also Japan plate also has a slow slip. And we want to know why such slow slip happens.
We don't know that we can, but if we can, then we have another tool where we can monitor the fault zone directly from the surface, which would be a first anywhere in the world if we can get it to work.